Both these players for getting to the semifinals get $150, and the winner of this will move to the final with a chance to win the $525 first prize, and second prize is $250. Not great money, but certainly a nice prize. I mean, I'm a firm believer that if this sport's ever really going to grow, there has to be some prize money. There has to be some benefits for the kids that are coming up, that they can look and say, that guy's a professional, I'm going to be like him. That he's making money, and he's playing table tennis, and he's going to be world class. And I think really without the money, I've been in the sport all my life, it's really never going to really go anywhere. I think that should be a push. I mean, there should be more money. Not that I would win it, but that all these youngsters see it, and there's somewhere to go, and that maybe there is a decision between going to college or maybe trying to make it. It's pretty difficult, though, that's for sure. And that's sort of my dream. I'll tell you, if I was president of the organization, and I once was, that was the way I was taking it. I mean, the prize money at the Nationals hasn't increased in 15 years. It's less than it was, 20 years ago. I mean, things like that, I think, is somewhat inexcusable. I mean, when you have the budget that the USATT has, and then the prize money is like that, I just think that clearly that's not a priority. It's just not a priority, and it isn't. And I think that's wrong. And that's just me, and I have a lot of opinions. I've been around this sport a long time, and I'm willing to share them. And if you don't like them, too bad. I'm still going to say them. I think that happens to you when you get older. I'll tell you, I'm a little different now. So I used to always be, my friend always said I was always Switzerland. I'm always nice, 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 nice. But someone, I speak my mind now, and I like it. It's kind of refreshing. Okay, back to table tennis. I'll get off my soapbox or whatever it was I was on. I do love commentating these matches. One, hopefully the drama of the match, and maybe, some of the techniques that are used. And we're ready to go. Semi-final, 2500. Hendawi to serve, Legaria to receive.
Hendawi with the serve, 0-0.
Heavy deep under.
1-0.
Nice side topspin serve and a good followed by Ahmed. He quickly jumps out 2-0 in game one.
0-2. Flat.
So far, not the rallies I was thinking, but it's way early. I got a feeling they should have some pretty good rallies, but Ahmed's offense can let him down. He likes it better to be a counter attacker. The only thing is Alex is kind of a counterattacker too, so that changes things. Nice and soft, nice and power. Five in a row.
5-2.
Nice serve, big loop. Kid's got a lot of spin on that loop, a nice smooth swing on that forehand loop. Ahmed's getting waxed. Started 2-0, and ever since then, it's been 7 straight. That's important, you know, when you got a string going, keep it rolling. You know, he's got 8 in a row, you know, and this is two guys that are rated exactly the same, but when you get it rolling, keep it going. Don't give anything away. And you can see Alex is not giving anything away. He's going to take it to the house.
9-2.
9-2. Wow, look at that. Can't give this kid time. He's very patient. I remember in our doubles match last night when he had time, he hardly missed. Wow, 2-0, and he lost. Ahmed has lost 10 in a row. Is it 11? No. Maybe a freebie. Little backhand banana. Game one is in the hopper.
Game two, Legaria.
Doesn't mean Legaria will win the match, but it's, you know, it's 3 out of 5. You got to get that good start. And Hendawi is a good blocker, but so far, I don't know. It just doesn't seem like the rhythm is there. But you can never give up. You can lose from 11-3. It means nothing. You can change your techniques. If you're down in a match, don't give up. You know, move your serve around. Change the arc of your loop. Block a little harder or a little safer. You know, just move it. All of a sudden, like this morning, actually, when I played Skolnick, I was not doing anything done. And then the side underserve to the backhand right away start opening things up, and I was like, wow, that's going to work. And I stayed there really the rest of the match, and it completely changed the match.
Second game, the guy with the serve. 0-0. 1-0.
Ahmed seems like he's not moving well. He's just sort of stepping to the ball instead of, you know, gliding and hopping. Yeah, he's got no chance. It's like he's sleeping.
0-2.
Oh man, he's backing up. What's he gonna do back there? He didn't do anything back there. Look at that nice control by Alex. And then you're not rushing, knowing he's got time.
0-3.
Oh, that's nice. That ball fell off the corner by like a half an inch, but Alex let it fall low and spun it up with an arc. Oh, yeah, this game is not good. Matter of fact, if you really kept the score, it's probably like 16 almost in a row for Legaria. I mean, come on. This is going to be 17. I can see that. So should Ahmed give up? Absolutely not.
0-6.
I think this is what he should be doing. He should be serving deep into his backhand. He should be serving short into his backhand. He should be putting absolute importance on the fact that the serve is not going long, and that Alex cannot let Alex start with this forehand, basically. And if he goes after Alex's backhand and plays the ball there, maybe he can get back in the match. But if he lets Alex spin that forehand and back up, and you know, it's wave the white flag. And he has to move. See that forehand hooks wide to Ahmed's backhand. Takes away his backing. That little side spin just gets wide. And you have to be careful because he can also go down the line. I guess now maybe kind of know why Ahmed didn't want to play on table one, two. He was wanting to play on table one. Maybe he's not feeling well this morning because he's certainly moving very slowly. And he's not fighting either. He's just tanking it in there.
10-2.
Well, I have to play in the next match, so I'm going to turn this over to Barbara Way, my partner. And I'll be up next with Mr. Skolnick, so hopefully you'll stay tuned and watch me play Mr. Skolnick in the semifinals.
As Danny mentioned, he's going to get ready for his next match, which is the semifinal of the Under 2500. So I'm back. This is Barbara, and I'll be here for the end of this match and to cover Danny's match, which is coming up right after this. This game is at least starting off a lot closer than the previous one. Under 2500 has been quite the Lindenwood battle. All the single elimination matches were Lindenwood versus Lindenwood, except for Danny. That was a great rally right there. And this is the quality of play that we should be seeing. The quality of play we should be seeing between these two players. He spoke with Ahmed earlier this tournament, and he has a little bit of a shoulder injury. Which may not be the best against this match against Alex. Alex has proven to be very steady with a great forehand, just never misses. Maybe off the serve, but it's pretty rare. That was a nice forehand. Again, we're seeing some better rallies.
7-4.
If Ahmed can keep moving and play his game, he's actually very consistent. He can make this match a lot closer. But he's not feeling great and it definitely showed in game two, although this game is going a lot better. There you go, Alex's forehand really doesn't miss very often. It's actually a very tough forehand loop, right where the ball barely came off the table.
5-8.
That was a nice rally.
9-6.
Ahmed really looking a little slow. Not moving.
6-11-6, game to Legaria.
Alex takes that game. 11-6, and just been kind of a slow match.